live, okay, so fatigue and tiredness, and you know, everyone can join in with whatever they're feeling at the moment. So fatigue is a word, okay, and everyone can sort of, you know, feel free to join in with whatever you're feeling. If you're feeling any kind of feelings, if you're in a state of infinite, limitless grace, or in the holy instant, then you don't need to do this. But otherwise, if you're feeling any form of limitation, this can be done as well. Because the fatigue is an experience of limitation. Okay. So first of all, is to ask, you know, how am I experiencing the fatigue? Realize that, okay, most things are like objects, or experienced like objects. So they have a shape. You know, if I hold this mug, can you see that it's got this shape? Now, fatigue, you know, like when I feel fatigue, it's like I have a foggy cloud, that I'm trapped inside like a foggy cloud. But how are you experiencing fatigue?
My eyes feel really heavy. Mm-hmm. I'm worried that I might noddle.
Okay.
I had a sort of a headachey thing, but that's gone now.
Yes.
It feels like a sluggishness. And I could pull something out of my bag to make me more alert, but I'd rather not do that when I'm here.
Okay. So, the thing with the sluggishness around the eyes, so is it like a cylinder around the eyes? Yeah.
It's like a helmet over the top of my
head. Great. Mm. So let's say there's a helmet here. Now, just try and let go of the thoughts. You don't need to identify with the thoughts, get lost in the story. So if there's a cylinder around the head, mm-hmm. If you open your eyes, you see this mug? It's like a cylinder. Are you this cylinder?
No.
You're the observer of the cylinder, aren't you? Now, if there's a shape, the observer of the shape can see the shape. Mm-hmm. So the observer can't be the shape. It can't be limited. It must be observing the shape. There must be an observer of a shape. The shape can't see the shape. The observer sees the shape.
Yeah.
Of the limit. So the helmet on the head, it's being observed.
Yes.
So there is observing of the helmet. Can you be the observing of the helmet?
And not feel it.
Well, is there an experience of being that which is witnessing the helmet?
Yeah.
Okay. So are you in the position of the witnessing now?
It feels a bit dual.
That's fine.
I'm kind of witnessing it, but experiencing it too.
Yeah, okay, excellent. So there's witnessing, and the witnesser is also experiencing the helmet.
Yeah.
So this is what we call an enmeshed witnesser, or an identified witnesser. It's a witnesser that has a relationship with the object, with the helmet. Okay, that's fine. So there's witnessing, and it's also connected to the helmet.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So is there something which is witnessing the enmeshed witnesser? So there's a witnesser that has a relationship with the helmet, but is there a detached witnesser that is witnessing that witnesser? Because when there's something enmeshed, there must be something that's watching the thing that's enmeshed.
Right.
Yeah. Because otherwise, what is witnessing the experience of something being enmeshed can't be the enmeshed bit. So there has to be something that's witnessing the enmeshment, which is not enmeshed, detached, essentially. Yeah. Is there a detached observer or witnesser or perceiver here? Is there something in this room which is not the helmet, which is watching everything?
Yes.
And can you experience being in this position?
It's coming and going.
Okay, that's great. So coming and going can happen. There is some spaciousness witnessing something and gets enmeshed. There is something getting enmeshed and then something detached and witnessing. and then it's flipping in and out. Okay. And there is also something which observes or perceives in and out. Like, you know, like let's say there's a wave going in and out.
Yeah.
But then there is a deeper observer that watches the wave going in and out, which is not the wave going in and out. And this witnesser that's watching the wave go in and out of enmeshment is detached from the wave going in and out. Is that here? Which is not having a relationship with in and out?
Okay, so
let that all go. So what's the experience now?
I still feel tired in a slightly different way.
So the tiredness,
yeah.
How are you experiencing it?
Really heavy eyelids, sort of heaviness across the top of my head.
Okay, so shall we do feel the feelings for a couple of minutes?
Yeah.
Yeah, so feeling the feelings, so it's like not resist, it's like the opposite of resisting. So it's fully welcoming it. And it's like, how does it feel?
Feels heavy. I think also because I know I can't go straight home after this. I've got theatre production I'm going to, and it's just thinking.
Okay. So let go, try and let go. When the thoughts come, try and let the thoughts go. And just allow this feeling fully to be here. Try and keep your back straight. Don't try and go into a sleepy, fall asleep position, and it's like fully welcome it. So it's like, you know, if you fully welcome it, but try not to go into thoughts. Try not to let it go.
Welcome the sleepy feeling.
Welcome the sleepy feeling. But sleepy is, even the word sleepy is a thought.
It is.
So it's really an energy. It's like a vibration, really. Because sleepy is a word.
Yeah.
Does that make sense?
It does.
And then you just allow it, and you just. Try not to go into sleep, and it's like you're welcoming it, and you're keeping the spine straight, and you're like welcoming it so that it fully is experienced, and so it can dissolve without resistance. When you don't resist a feeling and you just try and become one with it, then it will suddenly start to dissolve. And if you want to go into thoughts like labeling sleepiness, don't. You know, what I've got to do later on today, just detach from this and just be, it's almost like trying to be one with the feeling and stop resisting it or wishing it wasn't here.
Yeah.
Just fully let it be here. How's it going now in this room?
It's feeling a little bit better, actually.
Good. And as just keep feeling it, is it like an object or is it very diffuse, like a cloud?
More like a cloud.
Yeah, okay.
It's progress.
It's progress. And is there, so if there's this cloud here, are you aware of something which is witnessing the cloud? Even if there's subtle changes, yeah, there's a witness, sir. Good. And can you be that which is witnessing the cloud rather than being the cloud?
Today.
That's okay, that's fine. If you experience the witnesser, is the witnesser the cloud? Or is there detachment?
Detachment.
Yeah. So as you start to experience it, you soften it up, and then it becomes easier to do the witnesser. Sometimes in the beginning, if you can't do the witness, so you do feel the feelings, then it dissolves and fluffs out a bit. And then you can go to the observer of the fluffy cloud. It gets easier and easier. But as you notice, as soon as you're in the observer of the cloud is not tired. In that space which observes, there is no tiredness. But as soon as you're in the cloud, the experience is tiredness. And when you're in the observer of the cloud, suddenly there's no tiredness in the observing of the cloud. And as you flip to the observer, and stay, as you start to retain the observer rather than get lost in the cloud, you suddenly get your energy back, because the observer is like infinite energy, and being enmeshed in the cloud is like, well, I'm tired. So we'll do. So if it's okay with you, what we'll do is, because we'll be doing feeling the feelings soon, and we'll be doing putting things into God's infinite light and love and praying for a miracle, and we'll be doing cancelling tiredness and infinite being. So hopefully after we've done cancelling, putting it to God's infinite might and love, and felt it, and observed it, it should have some shifting.
I think I've just been bitten on my foot, so that's a good way to wake up.
You can fill that out as well.
Yeah.